A quick Google search and you can find out that the Philippines has 110 million inhabitants. Or Belarus, 9 million. Namibia, 2 million. But here, we will visualize it on a world map. Year by year, to see how the population of the world has changed.
One marker for every million inhabitants. Colors for every region. Blue for North America, green for South America, pink for Europe, yellow for Africa, purple for the Middle East, red for Asia, and orange for Oceania. Countries below 1 million are marked in white. And this is the world in 1950, 2.5 billion people. The baby boom era in parts of the world after the end of World War II, rebuilding economies in Europe. The United States had come out on top as the world's leading economy. In 1950, the world was plagued by high child mortality, and few nations had reached far in the demographic transition. In many ways, the nations of the world were divided into two categories. In the rich nations, economies were booming, mortality decreasing, teenage culture took its first baby steps, and there was no end in sight to the possibilities of the future. But in the poorer nations, basic health revolutions were in some instances still decades off. And within richer nations, of course, discrimination and segregation resulted in accumulated wealth only benefiting parts of the population. China and India will dominate this map from start to finish, and in 1954, China passes 600 million inhabitants, while India stands at 400 million. In 1960, the world passes 3 billion inhabitants. On this map, we use current-day borders and divisions, so the population of, for example, the Soviet Union is divided to its now sovereign republics. On this map, many nations were still colonies under foreign rule. In the early 1960s, we see Italy and Bangladesh pass 50 million respectively, a point that Pakistan passes in 1965 and France in 1968. India passes 500 million people in 1966, while China passes 700 million in 1964. 10 years after passing 600 million. A growth delayed partly by the devastating Great Leap Forward that killed 45 million people in the late 1950s, early 1960s. But passing 800 million took just 5 years, until 1969. A few years ahead of the moon landing, the US passes 200 million in 1966. Indonesia passes 100 million the year before, and Japan does the same the year after. By 1968, the Asian continent is home to 2 billion people. Despite all the population growth we will see after this and in the future, already in the 1960s, humanity reached the peak yearly growth rate at over 2%. This number has since been in sharp decline. By 1970, Mexico passes 50 million inhabitants as the world's 14th nation. And in 1973, Brazil passes 100 million. By 1974, Earth was home to 4 billion humans. In the same year, India passes 600 million inhabitants and China 900 million. 6 years later, China, under the economic reforms of Deng Xiaoping, is the first nation in human history with 1 billion inhabitants. In 1982, the Philippines passes 50 million inhabitants. Thailand does the same in 1983, Turkey and Egypt in 1986, and Iran in 1987. Pakistan passes 100 million in 1988, and Bangladesh passes the same milestone the year after. India passes both 700 million in 1981 and 800 million in 1986. Globally, 5 billion humans are alive in 1987, and Asia is home to 60% of that, passing 3 billion that same year. In the 1990s, India passes both 900 million in 1992 and becomes the second nation in history to pass 1 billion in 1997. China is by then way past 1.2 billion. Ethiopia passes 50 million in 1992 and Nigeria becomes the first African nation over 100 million that same year. In 1996, Africa passes Europe in population with 735 million. Indonesia passes 200 million in 1997. And just short of the new millennia, the global population passes 6 billion. Mexico passes 100 million in 2001, and the and the Democratic Republic of Congo passes 50 million in 2003. Myanmar and South Africa does the same in 2009. The Asian continent passes 4 billion in 2006, 3 years before the African continent passes 1 billion. The US is the third nation to pass 300 million in 2007. In 2011, the global 7 billion mark is passed, and now the population growth in Africa is driving the global development as some Asian nations are starting to slow down and even stagnate. Kenya and Tanzania pass 50 million. Ethiopia passes 100 million in 2015, doubling its population in just 23 years. Egypt passes the same number 4 years later, in 2019. Nigeria passes 200 million that same year. South Korea passes 50 million in 2012, the Philippines 100 million in 2014, and Pakistan 200 million in 2016. Brazil has passed 200 million in 2013, and also on the South American continent, Colombia passes 50 million in 2019. China has passed 1.4 billion by 2015. India now has a much higher growth than China, and is closing in on its northeastern neighbor. In 2022, India passes 1.4 billion inhabitants, just 7 years after China. And this is where we stand today, 7.9 billion people, set for overtaking 8 billion in just a year or so. Today, Asia is home to 60% of the world's population, the largest continent by far. Africa comes in second with 18% of the global population, while Europe is home to only 9%. 13% live on the American continents and 1% in Oceania. Even though we have learned more and more of the challenges with a large human population, not the least from an environmental perspective, we are far from the 18th and 19th century Malthusian paradigm. British economist Thomas Malthus pointed to the problem with overpopulation and that food production could never keep up with an exponentially growing global population. With industrial production and technological development, the yields per acre have increased by several 100%, and we today produce more calories of food than would be necessary to feed the human population comfortably. The more positive view of human ability was, for example, presented by American Nobel Prize laureate in economics, Eleanor Ostrom. The issue today is more with distribution and political interference. We also produce a significant share of the total yields for animal feed and biofuels that could be used for direct human consumption. We also today know that the population will not grow exponentially until reaching carrying capacity. If you want to know more about why nations go through a period of fast population growth and how fertility and mortality rates come into play, I can recommend my video on the demographic transition. I also have videos on the population development of specific nations, for example, China and Russia. You can find links to those videos in the description below.
Where we will go from here, only the future can tell. But with projections, we can predict and prepare. And we will look at estimations of the population in 2100 in a later video. If you like my content, there is more to see on my channel. And if you subscribe and activate notifications, you can see what I make in the future. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.